taboo, sensual touch. Erotic taboo, sensual touch.
Touch me, kiss me, squeeze me. Touch me.
You're listening to the Intimacy Chronicles. I am your host, Queen Jackie. Tonight, well, before we get into that, let me just allow the men to introduce themselves. To my right.
Good evening, folks. Everyone out there in IG, at Facebook, and Computer Land, retro, also known as the Quiet Storm.
Mm-hmm. And to my left.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy, Big Nate, a.k.a. Dr. Love. All you people out there in TV land, what's happening?
Okay, so so tonight's show, is the men's choice. So whatever the men want to discuss, that's what we're going to be discussing. It's a freestyle night for the men. So be warned, because it could go left fast. But before we get into our topic, I'm actually going to have to allow Dr. Love, since he was kind of, he didn't get a chance to talk about his production last week, and he's a bit temperamental, so let me just let him have those 3 minutes.
I am fine.
You're fine?
I am. Mike, check. No, I'm fine.
So you're
fine.
Done with that?
I'm fine. Shout okay. out to the What If crew. Yeah.
Okay. So, how was your weekend?
Had a good weekend. We had a homegoing service for a good friend of mine.
Okay.
I don't remember. I don't know if you remember Stacy,
yeah.
who sings in our group.
Mm-hmm.
Her mom passed, and she was a big fan of the band. She used to come out and support us. So we had a service. Well, they had a service for her homegoing service on Saturday, where. I actually played during the service, and the cool thing about it is, after the service, everyone kind of just gravitated to the house.
Okay.
And man, that family is such a, not only talented, but it's just a lot of fellowship.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just picture this: Will playing piano in his living room, and everybody from 8 to 80 getting up there singing and can sing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just a lot of talent in the family.
Yeah.
And then he was like, well, bring your drum. I'm like, bring my drum. So I'm in the middle of all a group of people singing and playing. So it was really fun. Mm-hmm. And then your boy Dexter
he's still single. Okay.
But they It was really such an honor and privilege to be
that was good.
Included in the fellowship of their family.
Okay.
Yeah.
That was good. It's been, for me, it's been a lot of death going on, you know. We buried Hurl's aunt Friday. I told you about Cassie's mom.
Yes.
And I'm hoping... It was something else. Oh, yeah, my sister-in-law, her sister-in-law passed, so that funeral is this week as well. So it's a whole lot of stuff going on right now. And I think with all of that going on, I actually had a chance to do some soul searching, and I feel like a lot of times we spend so much unnecessary time being angry.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And when you've had so much death, it's a reminder of how precious life can be, and why waste energy being unhappy, angry? I mean, we're still here, so mm-hmm. we can make changes in our lives.
That's a very good point, because you're absolutely right. Some people have the mentality, or what to say, being angry, mm-hmm. being upset, whatever negative mood that you partake in or you feel is a choice. So it's you have a choice whether or not to look at the positive side, or you have a choice to bask in the negativity.
Yeah.
You know, and you're absolutely right. I'm glad you had a chance to reflect, because that's something all of us need to do.
Absolutely. You know, especially in these every day times. You wake up, that's your chance. You mm-hmm. don't like how things are going in your life, okay, do something about it.
Absolutely.
But nobody wants to hear your constant bitching. You know, make some changes so that you can become the best version of yourself. That's where I'm at right now. So if you're coming to me with a sad story, I'm not saying that I can't have a listening ear. What I'm saying is, my question at the end of that conversation is, what are you going to do about it? What changes are you going to make?
No, I want to sit here and vent and you have can you feel sorry for
get
me.
It out. Get out what you got to say, but keep that shit moving.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I don't want that energy in my space.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like there are so many amazing things in life to enjoy, and we each have the same opportunity the minute you wake up, and that's to make a change.
I like
make a
that.
Change for the better.
I like that. Yeah. I don't want that energy in my space, Facebook, IG, or
Pornhub.
Black Planet, remember that?
Yeah, Black Planet was the shit.
I know, man, Black Planet. I still got my account open.
Oh, God. I don't even know the password.
Wow. Was that Christian Mingle?
Yeah. Yeah.
You're the bigot freaks.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my God.
Be like, what's your Christian Mingle name? Will, God's will.
See? I believe that's your name. I believe that really is your name.
God will do.
Pastor Cavoisier.
Damn. That's a good one.
Let me stop. Oh, it's more. It's more. It's more than that.
It's more than that. He probably got about 5 accounts. So it's y'all night. What y'all want to talk about?
Well, you forgot my man. Hey, what you do over the weekend, man?
I
thoughtin' and bopping.
Yeah, right. No, my weekend was good.
Okay. Y'all got your own remix going.
It's good.
You good. Some things was loose.
Yeah.
Somebody moved some.
A little bit of technical difficulties.
Somebody shake some more.
Right.
He said. Some things was loose. The mic was loose too.
Yeah. We kept thinking it was the mic. It was actually over here. You good?
If you go live, go on Instagram live.
Okay. I had a good weekend. It was a nice weekend. I mean, productive and. But I had a beautiful weekend Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
But then, you know, found out we had death.
Wow.
Not in the family, but in the church family.
Okay. And
somebody who I knew since I had first joined the church in 92. And I guess it started off with an infection. And he went to the hospital. From what I'm hearing, I went to and thought he had got everything cleared up, and then they let him go from the hospital. And then the next thing you know, passed away. So I'm like, Jesus, like they just like, you know, people dropping like flies.
Yeah.
So now it's to the point. Now I've been at that point, but now I'm to the point where you know. at 40 years old, you know, I got to live life to the fullest. You know what I'm saying? Different things that I want to do, different things that I want to try. You know what I'm saying? Like the bucket list. You know what I'm saying? I want to go ahead and get it done. You know what I'm saying? You know, but other than that, it is what it is. It is what it is. So, you know, like just what y'all was saying, man, all that negativity. You know, people want to be negative and bring that stuff in your life. And I ain't got time for that. I really don't. I mean, I don't mind helping you if you can take the help and move on and gravitate. But if you can't gravitate and you still want to have that shovel in your back pocket, I can't talk to you. So,
everybody, you know, has a choice.
You know, but yes.
Oh, we had a memorial or something.
You're real funny, man. You're a real funny guy.
But that's, I'm not going to lie, that's kind of like the path you was on.
Yeah, so, and look, yeah. I was getting ready to go to mine.
Because I'm like, well, goddamn, was this the intimacy chronicle?
You know, 4 weeks ago.
Soliloquy chronicle.
It was okay.
You know, 4 weeks ago, I almost lost my life.
Getting out the shower.
I know I was falling down and I tried to grab onto the water.
I feel like we should be singing May the work I've done speak for me. You know what I mean? God,
oh
damn.
My God. Should have been ready to pass the offering plate. Oh,
damn,
man.
I got to build
funny.
My energy level back up. This motherfucker done dragged me down to the bottom.
No. I mean, in other news.
Yeah, go with it.
Gas prices are up like a motherfucker. Gas prices are up.
I never look.
$2.53.
God damn it.
Right before Memorial Day. Jeez.
Of course, yeah. But I never look at that because I know I need gas. So I'm not going to drive a few blocks away just because their gas is cheaper. Whatever area I'm in, I'm going to get the gas right then and there because I'm probably going to spend a little bit more going a few miles down just to get the cheaper gas. So
this is the talk of somebody who drives a four-cylinder. So naturally,
but
they
no,
can talk
even,
that shit.
Even when I had the Maxima, I didn't ride
for her. That was a six-cylinder.
Hey, this for Jackie right here.
I didn't ride all around looking for cheap gas. That's Jackie. Whatever area I was in, that's where I'm getting gas at because I know I need this.
No, that's one thing I will not do. Drive all over Baltimore City.
Yeah, the hell.
Over east, they got the cheap gas, but then you got to go all the way back over west.
Yeah, you done burnt that.
Drive
that's why you gotta get DJs. DJs and motherfucking Sam.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know Sam's.
Oh, BJ's though.
BJ gas is good.
Oh,
what about Costco?
What do blowjobs
Costco?
Costco
do they do gas?
I think
they do propane.
Well, I know the one that owns. There you go. There you go. He's back.
He's back.
So, Mickey. You know, we haven't had the opportunity to really go into the R. Kelly shit. And I don't... I want to go into it from a different standpoint.
Okay.
Damn.
Because, yeah, he was wrong on so many levels. But should he be the only one held accountable? Because I tend to believe that us as parents should never allow our children to go stay with someone because of what it could possibly do to their career. You know what I'm saying? So aren't the parents negligent too?
Well, well, I would say this. It was one girl that who was determined. You know, it, and part of you say, ain't no way I let my 14-year-old do this and that, but she was determined, like, if she was going to hitchhike or catch a plane or meet up with him, she would have did it, you know.
And that's
the one who sent her her sister.
Right. I remember that, yeah. And I understand that, but I still say at 14... You don't dictate
what the fuck you gonna
exactly.
do.
Exactly. So again, some of that responsibility I feel like falls at the parents' feet as well.
A lot of it does.
Yeah,
yes, I
exactly.
do agree, but
you're gonna let them go with somebody just because they're an entertainer? That doesn't mean that they are trustworthy, and these are your babies.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so yeah, you have a responsibility too. The people in his camp that knew he was doing these things, they yeah. have a responsibility as well.
Absolutely.
Yeah. They didn't report his ass because they didn't want their money source to be cut off.
Exactly.
You know, so I think there are so many people that should be brought up on charges as a result of this. Yeah. And since we're talking about R. Kelly, because he's not the only one. You know, now that he's up on charges,
Robert.
And, you know, first of all,
y'all trying to kill me.
Those the actions are ridiculous. You know what I'm saying? Because first he asks, "Is this camera? Is this camera on? Is this camera on? Is
y'all
this camera
about,
on
you know,
me?
This shit about to be remixed.
Is this camera on me?
Right." So now you want to fall all out and shit, but you weren't saying that or doing any of that when you were taking advantage of these young women.
Is this came on me? Think with your head. Hate me if you want. Love me if you want.
Hey.
Think with your head.
Gayle King is shit, though.
Ain't she?
She sat there like,
Robert. That's that psychology She's degree.
Smooth. She was smooth. Like
She was like, Robert, you bitch. Know.
All the yelling don't faze me, Robert.
Exactly.
You know
but
what?
You know when Robert. He was yelling, it made me think of Robert. That's how he is when he's with
Robert.
Those young ladies.
Robert.
That's what I thought about.
Robert.
See, if I was R. Kelly, I'd have been like, nah, Gayle. That's rumors.
Yeah, I'll put people my dick in talk. Your mouth, Gayle.
No, I'll be like, Robert.
That's probably what he was thinking.
He probably said, Gayle, I'll put this dick in your mouth. She was like,
Robert.
But look, hear me out. Because that's the way he should have came back with her, to her. Ain't nothing but rumors. Same kind of rumors when they said you and Oprah was fucking.
The interview would have been over.
Oh,
the interview would have been over.
That would have been a good
one. She would have been like,
cut. Yeah. Man, God damn.
Don't come up here. You know, that's what I was thinking.
But if he would have been smart, he would have said that.
No, but y'all know. I would have been like, yeah,
we
all victims of this.
Robert.
Right. He was trying to clear his name.
But nobody's.
That's my understanding.
Don't be judgmental.
He wanted to stop the interviews of the two young ladies as yeah, well.
He was.
Yeah. They said that the accuser. The accuser wants to serve him, but his security is so tight, it's hard to get the paperwork.
Son.
I'm surprised they still...
You think that's
terrible.
Let's be real. That was really your daughter. You think security going to stop you from doing something to
And
him?
That's exactly it. Absolutely.
I've been waiting for his ass to come out that jail with that ugly ass blue jacket and beat the shit out of him.
But now ain't they at the age of consent? It's not. Ain't they over 18 now?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah, but I believe he still can get charged because he was seeing them when they wasn't.
Right. Yeah. But right now, it's nothing the parents could legally do because if they want to stay with them, they can because they're at the age of consent now. And that's the thing about it is if he was smart, but I understand this is a sickness.
Yeah.
So it's not like he, it's not, when you're at that level, and you're, mm-hmm. It's not much you can do.
Because I believe he convinces himself that he did nothing wrong.
He's tough. He think he's tough. He think he can get over it. Yeah,
exactly.
Because he doesn't say I'm innocent. He said, I beat the charges. Or he talks about
beating the charges.
That's it. Yeah.
I want you to think.
Yeah. Robert.
Why would I have people in my basement and I feed them? And nothing. Not unless they want to go to get their hair done down the street.
But also what happened this week, remember those two girls from Baltimore came forward, right?
They had the ugly ass hairstyles too.
But I'm saying that the story you know, where she at the Baltimore Grand and the hotels, and she walked. Did you see that on?
I didn't see that.
Oh my God!
Well, I might pull that shit up.
Yeah, it was on the local news. I think Channel 13 aired it.
Robert.
He came to the Baltimore Arena. Mm-hmm. And for a show, and they went to the after party at the Baltimore Grand. He picked them out of the audience and then had them up in a hotel room. And then when he came in, exposing himself, one of them locked herself in the bathroom, and then the other one got raped.
Damn.
Yeah. And then what happened was, the thing about it is, another woman, she was leaving, she was walking down the hall, the hotel hall, mm-hmm. holding her stomach because they said that the sex was like rough.
Yeah.
So she was holding her stomach, bent over, and another woman, girl, saw her get into the elevator. Wow. And she's the one who came and said she never knew who she was. So now when she came out, she said, yes, I saw when you came out.
Okay.
So it's three of them. So it's two girls and then one that could corroborate the story.
Wow.
Now that's close to home. That's in Baltimore, you know?
But I think there are so many cases that we haven't even heard about.
And
these rumors have been going, I mean, I don't think they're all rumors, but this has been going on for a long time. And now that, you know, a lot of it is coming out on the forefront, now you have a lot of celebrities distancing themselves from him, but some of those same people were aware of
what he was doing.
Exactly. So now, because it's a big public thing, you want to separate yourself, but you were aware of it and you still continue to make music with him.
And I'm gonna be completely honest in this, like, it disgusts me now.
Yeah.
Accusing R. Kelly of sexually assaulting them after.
Oh, I got it up, y'all. Okay. Damn, I should have
like,
said
that. It disgusts me now, but I remember back in 95, 96,
mm-hmm.
when we was hearing about this, I still bought his CD.
Yeah,
I still listened
to
his music.
I did too.
And it was like a joke, you know what I'm saying, while this stuff was going on. And I wasn't fazed about it. And I'm thinking, as an adult, well, now when I look back at it, I was like, why didn't that disgust me then? What was it about me that wasn't upset as I was now?
I think we're all guilty at one time or another for putting entertainers, sports figures, pastors, and the list goes on pedestals.
Yeah, making jokes about it.
Realizing that they are human,
mm-hmm.
you know, and they fall short. Now, when the tape was out, I was still listening to his music and mm-hmm. stuff.
Robert.
So I think that we all bear responsibility.
Robert.
You know, so.
Robert.
But his shit is played out in the media, but what about the ones who aren't?
Robert.
You know, because are they still talking about Weinstein?
Robert.
Are they still talking about Charlie Sheen?
No, tell me with this.
You know, I mean, it's like the list goes on, but I feel like a lot of times our people are played out in the media more so than their white counterparts.
I know. And I think there's, because these are girls of color, that's why.
It's no priority.
And so when you say guilt, who's to blame? I put myself in that too.
Yeah, because that's why I say we're all guilty.
I wasn't outraged at the time, you know, and I gave him a pass.
Yeah.
And I was still singing the song 12 play, you know, feeling on your booty, all of that stuff.
You know what I feel?
Richard.
I know.
Richard.
Yeah, remix that, Richard.
Richard.
You know what I feel guilty because.
Oh, Gail did not come for me. I got something for her.
I used to sell black market and DVDs. I used to sell black market CDs and DVDs.
Uh-huh.
And I sold the shit out of that tape.
That 12 play.
Yeah. Man, when that shit hit.
12 play was nice.
I had to go to New. No, I'm talking about the video.
Oh, the video.
Pissing.
Okay. Oh, wow. Yeah,
I sold
man.
Over 2,000 of them.
Wow.
Easy.
Damn, man.
I had to go to New York 3 times that fucking week.
But that's why I say at one point or another, we all bear responsibility.
You got Ray. You got
That's
Ray
the
J.
thing now.
You still got Ray J and Kim Kardashian
peeing on the women.
They're trying to kill me.
Nick, you still got Ray J and
well,
Kim
let's
Kardashian.
Change gears for a second.
You still got Ray J and Kim Kardashian.
I can get it.
Yeah, but that made you famous, didn't it?
Oh man.
You know, I feel like a lot of times with these celebrities, they get away with so much because of who they are. And we bear a responsibility as a society in that role, too.
Yeah.
You know, because of the pedestal that we put them on.
We gave him a pass.
We gave him a pass.
He was telling us all along, you think about
this. And I didn't realize that until I started going back listening to, you know, a lot of his music. Mm-hmm. But then
he said he was on the down low. Yeah. With little girls, but we ain't know.
Yeah.
Is this camera on me?
But again, when you start thinking about when I hear different stories of people saying when you go to the studios and he got all these young girls in there, you see this and you still don't report this shit?
I know.
Yeah.
Because
but at least he tried to be honest. Because he tried to come forward in one of his songs where he said...
All of his songs.
My mind was telling me no.
I can't with you.
Man, please.
But my body... My body telling me yes.
Now I got to read this comment from About Me and Mine. She says, man, he wrong, but R. Kelly music will still be played by me. Too many hits to throw his musicology away. Yes, like those women who paid their kids way to college, they didn't earn. I agree. I think
that's real shit.
And I think to say that I'm not going to listen to R. Kelly's music, I'd be lying. You know what I'm saying? And that's just being honest.
I mean, hands down, he's a music genius.
Exactly. Exactly.
Gotta give it to him.
Now he's gonna be ghostwriting.
Gotta give it to
him. For the rest of his life.
And the man been in the business for years.
Is he on Pandora? Is he still Pandora still playing?
Yes.
They
is? Yes.
Are they? Okay.
But you can't even do Pandora anymore because let's say you try to make love with Pandora on.
And that motherfucking commercial come on.
Oh, O'Reilly.
You pay the $4.99 so you don't have to hear that shit.
Now you gotta go in the commercial and say, I am R. Kelly and I'm a black man and I love kids. At the Red House.
I sent you that, didn't I?
I didn't download.
That's what the second half.
I waited all week. I know they're going to forget.
I didn't even know that he had sent like a couple of more videos because I didn't get them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
I was
then
ready.
He gonna call me talking about I'm gonna take y'all phones away from y'all, and he the main one sending videos.
I was ready, and she was like, "We gonna sing it tonight." I was studying that song at the Red House. Well, black people and white people vibing here. I said, he really made a commercial like that?
Yeah. Well, we need to preface it. We need it because we need to loop
people
in.
I might pull it up.
All right.
It's on YouTube. Also on YouTube.
Yes. Yeah.
So here it is. It's the story about the Red House. I was listening to another station, syndicated station, morning show, and they actually brought it up.
Mm-hmm.
And they played the clip, and I was like, man, this is crazy. So I was intrigued, so I pulled up the commercial. So it's a commercial for a furniture store in North Carolina, which is like over the top. It's mm-hmm. it's low budget but very catchy.
It was very catchy
and they just hit the diversity thing straight on, no holds barred. And my question was, I was like, I would totally buy furniture from them. And I did not get a chance to look at the comments on YouTube,
R. Kelly Red House Furniture?
No, Red House Furniture.
Oh, Red House Furniture.
R. Kelly ain't got shit to do with it. We done moved past that.
Well, we'll circle back.
We're going to come back to the R. Kelly thing, but
The black and white shit.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I got that shit.
But when I think about the commercial, I applaud them for thinking outside the box.
Yeah.
You need great marketing videos.
Yeah, I felt like it was definitely a great marketing.
It looked like it was a Force commercial too.
You think so?
Yeah.
All right, so you ready?
Did you see what the guy? We went on the bed. He said, "This bed is made for white people."
And black people.
Let him cue it up.
Y'all ready?
Yeah, we ready.
So let's listen.
Let me turn off the R. Kelly shit.
We're going to come back to R. Kelly.
Here we go.
High Point, North Carolina. Putting y'all on the
map. We all just get along at the Red House Furniture. We can.
At the Red House.
This shit is funny.
I'm Richard, a.k.a. Big Head. I work at the Red House, and I'm black.
At the Red
House. I like pumping iron and pumping furniture into people's homes.
That's your first time seeing it.
I'm Johnny, a.k.a. T-Engage. I work at the Red House, and I'm white. I like deer hunting, bass fishing, and extending credit to all people.
At the Red House.
I'm black, and I love the Red House.
I'm white, and I love the Red House.
I'm a black woman, and I love the Red House.
She must have got a good couch.
I am white, and the Red House is for me.
At the Red House.
Man, that shit is catchy. I'm telling you.
Hold up.
Look at the sofa. It's perfect for a black person or a white person.
This mattress is perfect for a white person.
The videos are true.
Or a black person.
At the Red House, where black people and white people buy furniture.
And Hispanic people, too.
And all people.
Yo.
Oh, my God.
This shit is dumb.
Yo, but you know, I know that because I'm always interested in people views, and I think they got like 6 million views.
Hispanic people, too.
Yeah.
So that's the question, Nick.
They
would you
put outside the box would you when buy, they made would that you, commercial?
What you think?
Now, I was shocked there. Just going that.
I was too, and I mean, let's High Point, North Carolina. Great furniture is made there.
Yeah, but, and they kept it real.
Yeah, exactly.
Now let's be honest.
Okay.
After that was aired, their furniture stock probably went the fuck sky high.
Yeah, no bullshit.
They probably had a pig on the grill offering big discounts at the Red House.
Yeah, exactly.
That shit is catchy. I'm not gonna lie.
And oh my God.
Originality, yeah.
6.6 million views.
Yeah.
What threw me off is both of the white guys looking, I don't know what the fuck they looking at, but they're like, at the Red House.
And they had harmony, you know.
Yeah, that was on point.
Exactly.
You know what? I think they was all smoking weed one day, and somebody sang that shit, and they said, fuck it, we going to make a dumbass commercial.
Nah, Nick, I think it was moonshine. You got to look at where they are.
Okay.
All right, so look, I'm gonna read some of the comics, right? Most of everything is positive so far.
Yeah.
I nominate this video for a Nobel Peace Prize. Pretty much how black and white people interact in the South and Hispanics.
Yeah.
Look, ha ha ha, brilliant. I never knew that black and white people had separate furniture before the Red House.
Well, now you know.
Now, I ain't gonna lie. When he did that swan dive on that couch, I know you sure that son of a bitch was gonna break. But it was sturdy as a motherfucker.
Yeah, and that's what I'm telling y'all. Great furniture is made in High Point, North Carolina. That's probably, if it's not, I don't know. I think they might be the furniture connection of the country.
Yeah.
You know, I know their stock went up. Comes out of High Point.
I know their stock went sky high.
Yeah, the last comment. They need to open up a Red House furniture store in the Middle East so Arabs and Jews can buy furniture.
Yo! Damn.
Oh, man.
Let me see. At the Brown House, where the Jews and the Arabs buy furniture.
Really, man?
Really, man?
Oh, okay, really.
He said, "And yeah. Yeah, but like I said, that takes some balls to do something like that. It's they were out there.
It was ballsy. Yeah. You know, I mean, hell, 6.6 million views. It's a great point because yes, we all buy furniture. They just happen
to the Red House.
Make a song about
it. Yeah, good luck getting that out of your head now.
Exactly. When
you after I watched that,
I just kept walking around talking about at the Red House. I was like, damn, I could hit that shit.
See, I stopped singing it after I saw it. Let's say 20 minutes after I saw it. The only thing I couldn't get out of my head is,
yeah, I'm a black person. Video.
I'm a black person.
And I like Red
House. And I like to eat chicken.
Here we go.
I like to go to the Red House.
Here we go.
But you know what? The shit he said really wasn't like, he didn't say eat chicken and shit. He didn't really say no real black shit.
Yeah.
Okay, so was the commercial racist?
No,
I'm gonna say no.
I'm gonna say no.
Nothing racist about
it.
It caught me off though.
The only thing about it is they kind of narrow view because it's more than black and white people. It's more racist than just black and white people. But you know what I mean. But
that's true. If you think of the area that they're in, it's probably predominantly black and white.
Okay, so let's be honest.
More area specific.
When you first seen it, did you think it was racist?
Oh yeah, I was ready.
I ain't even gonna lie. When I first seen it, I was like,
"Fucking yeah, yeah, like, what the fuck is this?"
Yeah, I think I didn't draw a conclusion because I wanted to see all of it. Because first of all, the shit was catching, and then I was like, But after I listened to the entire thing, man, I'm telling you, I really thought it was ballsy.
Yep. I was like, when I was first listening, I was like, "Come on." And then next thing you know, towards the end, and I was like, I just started laughing.
I said to myself, "I'm glad I don't live in that motherfucker city. Man. I'm glad I don't live down there. I'll be going to Value City.
Please,
get my furniture.
I need
the thrift store.
I need IKEA to step up their commercial game.
Yeah, exactly. Because that has got to be the best furniture commercial
of all time.
They
didn't take the plastic off the bed.
They didn't need a big budget to do it.
They didn't take the plastic off the bedding. He jumped on it like.
You can hear the noise. Yeah.
Hey, they added that shit good.
Yeah.
He almost forgot his line.
He couldn't do a better job than that.
He almost forgot his line.
But he started out with, "Hi, my name Rich, aka Big Head. I like
and
pumping
iron." About you because.
Get up.
Because the name is Rich, so you do have a big head.
Damn!
Oh, why him? Could be.
Look, she ain't lying.
Oh,
you
man.
You get a low one for that.
Yeah,
a
low one.
Yeah, the struggle is real.
And I just thought, goddamn, it's so. How odd is it that his name is
Rich? And he had a big head, yeah.
The struggle is real.
He's like, I like pumping iron, extending credit, and pushing furniture into your house.
I think I might have to take these R. Kelly things and make it a drop.
No, killing me with this.
He sounded like Will Smith.
Man, they joked that man.
Absolutely right.
He said, they had to joke that man so bad, they didn't came up with his own club mix.
Oh, I got it.
Please hear that, please?
Yes,
so we're back to R. Kelly. Let's hear the R. Kelly club mix.
I had to fuck
don't crunch it down at the rodeo.
I can't hear 30 years of my
Robert.
30 years of my career. Y'all trying to kill me. Y'all just don't want to believe the truth. You don't want to believe it.
At this point, we briefly pause the interview to give Kelly a moment.
He hurt.
That is going viral. Everybody is dancing to this right here. It's viral.
I played that shit this weekend.
Where?
Them motherfuckers went off.
Wow.
Twice. I had 2 gigs this weekend. They went the fuck off at both gigs off this shit. And I got 3 different versions. I had to make the shit longer.
Okay. Wow.
See?
They wouldn't let you start, let it stop playing.
Yo.
Jesus damn. Wow.
So what's the main hook? Y'all killing me with this?
Yeah, y'all killing me with this shit.
Wow.
And it's going viral.
I'm sure he needs
it. I know it's whoever remixed.
I'm sure he could use the royalties.
It's already over a million views.
That's another thing. Okay, so it's reported that he's made in excess of $100 million. Mm-hmm. It is hard for me to believe he's broke. I think that he has money out the country, but I don't believe he's broke.
When I heard that, I was like,
pull up the R. Kelly video.
Damn.
Where he was in Ethiopia.
No.
You saw that one?
No, please don't.
So we're not going to do the Baltimore shit, right? You passed that? Because I do got that up.
Got it up. Let's cue it up. This is the Baltimore interview.
The Baltimore interview.
Women are accusing R. Kelly of sexually assaulting them after his concert in our city back in 1996. Young teens at the time, they snuck out to see their idol perform at the Baltimore Arena. And tonight, they are telling their story exclusively to WJZ. And in a major development, another Baltimore woman has come forward, a witness to what happened at a downtown hotel.
Well, they edit this shit. Brian Pookie, where you at?
May 31st, 1996, R&B superstar R. Kelly's Top Secret Tour storms the Baltimore Arena.
Brian Pookie!
For best friend 16-year-old Latrice Scaff and 15-year-old Rochelle Washington, it's the concert of their young lives. They're so excited they call into 92Q.
They heard us live all over the radio. People heard us all over the city.
The concert ends, but the night is far from over. The girls have flyers for an after party at the Baltimore Grand Nightclub at Saratoga and Howard. They're living a dream.
R. Kelly was scoping us out through a crowd.
The women tell WJZ they are given marijuana and alcohol, then invited back to the hotel with R. Kelly. At what point did it turn from exciting and cool, R. Kelly, to... terror.
He entered the room already, exposing himself to us.
Scared, Rochelle shut herself in the bathroom. That's when Latrice alleges R. Kelly sexually assaulted her, something she describes at a recent news conference.
When Kelly was alone with me, he asked me to perform oral sex on him.
She got some good lips, yo.
Under the influence of marijuana and alcohol, and I did it.
Robert.
He then had sexual intercourse with me, even though I did not have the capacity to consent.
And in incredible development, a local woman saw that news conference and instantly recognized the women and their story.
Sabrina.
23 years after Sabrina saw Latrice stumbling off the hotel elevator, these women are reunited for the first time with WJZ cameras rolling. An emotional, overwhelming moment. Knowing that together they will see justice against R. Kelly.
I've thought about them for many, many years.
Did you know how old she was at that point?
No, but I knew they were young. You could clearly see she was in pain. She was in pain. She couldn't walk. She was bent over, walking alongside of the wall. And she began to tell me that she was in a room with R. Kelly and... you know, they had sex, it was very rough. And he left her on the bed and said he would come back. He never came back. Security came and told her Robert said meet him in the lobby.
You can corroborate their story.
I sure can.
The fact that she's been waiting for for us to do, you know, come forward. It's just... I can't believe it. I'm just really shocked.
They tell the same story, even though they haven't spoken nor seen each other since that night. They are now represented by Gloria Allred, a nationally prominent attorney who prosecutes high...
She got a license in every state?
Probably.
Yes. She is killing them.
My man said they were the...
the knock 'em down broads.
But let me say this.
From down the avenue.
You go to a concert. You're picked out of the crowd to hang out with, in their case, probably their idol. You know, they're excited. You know, I mean, I'm sure there was a lot of feelings going through them. And then you go to his room and you're taken advantage of.
Yeah.
And remember, imagine how devastating that is.
And remember, I don't know if y'all picked this up. It was two of them in there.
What's supposed to happen if you go to a room?
It was two of them in the room. And one of them got away.
Let me just say that, because when you... I think that's an easy statement for a man to make.
No, what I'm saying...
Okay, let me finish.
What I'm saying is that if you already heard... If I heard history of an R&B person, okay, I'll go and see them. But to go to their room, even if the rumors are not true, I'm not going to their room.
But at that point,
unless I'm expecting something.
Girls?
They were 16. At that point, first of all, they snuck out to go to the concert, right? They down there by themselves. They were given marijuana and liquor. So they were probably already under the influence by the time you got to the hotel.
Right.
And they knew but at the same time the handlers and R. Kelly knew what to do with them. Because
exactly.
And that's why I always say, I don't care how you're a grown man. I don't care how the girl, 16 or 15 or whatever, if she comes on to you and she wants this and she wants that, she's off limits, because it ain't even fair.
Yeah.
For a man to seduce a 16-year-old.
Yeah.
So, you know what I mean? Because it's two different mindsets, and that grown man knows exactly what to say to that young girl.
And these are impressionable
women. Yes.
They are given the opportunity to hang out with somebody they idolize.
Yeah.
Now, I think it's such a when women report such behavior, it's always about, you knew what was going to happen when you went to this person's room. And I think that's a sexist statement, in the sense to where it goes back to men thinking that they have a right to force themselves on you because of that same mindset. You're dressed a certain way, so I have a right because you're asking for it. I don't think those girls asked for it. I think that they wanted to hang out with their idol.
Well, part of that is, I think the girls knew what the deal was, but they wasn't expecting it to be that way.
To be like
that. You
see
what I'm saying?
Exactly.
To be horrifying like
that.
Exactly. You know, and I don't think it's a... And I always challenge you when you go into men versus women, because women do the same. Women can have the capacity to do the same thing.
I'm not saying they don't.
It's an age difference. Whenever you have a mature person, like a mature woman knows how to seduce a young boy, the same way a mature man knows how to seduce a young female. But the issue is, as an adult, that's where we have to show restraint. I mean, come on now. You had... I'm sure every man at some point had some little girl, had a little crush on you.
Right.
And you don't embrace it. You don't encourage it. You have to shut it down and keep your distance. And if you get those kind of vibes, you have to keep your distance. Plain and simple. And that's what should have happened.
Yeah. And the reason I made that statement, because this isn't just something that happens now. This is generational behavior that
Elvis,
has happened. Exactly.
Buddy Holly.
Exactly. And if we're going back, because Elvis, Priscilla was what, 14 or 15 when he married
her? She was like 9 years old.
They still continue to play his music. They still celebrated this man. Jerry Lee Lewis married his 13-year-old cousin.
Robert.
Woody Allen. His baby.
Woody Allen. Yeah. Exactly. So, I mean, these men were still celebrated, and I think that it continues to... I think that not all men, but I still think there's that old way of thinking, like it is their right
now,
to be able to do that.
Now, I gave Nick the video of
Yeah, got it.
R. Kelly wilding out in Africa, but you got to realize in Africa it's worse because they are like 14 and 15 year old girls that are being married off to 40-year-old men. You know, because they come of age because of whatever.
But if you go back to The Color Purple, you seen The Color Purple, right?
Yeah.
And those girls were like 13 and being married to, you know, older men, old enough to probably be their grandfather.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? It was a time where that was okay. But
now it was different.
It's a different thing now.
So you want to, Nick? You want to cue that up?
Yeah, I got
you. So this is the video of R. Kelly a few years back when he went to Ethiopia.
I hope this is the right one.
Now I got to read this before play that.
The one where he sung to him.
Do you have your past?
All right.
Huh?
Go ahead.
Oh, so About Me and Mine says, I went to the 12 play tour. I was 12 or 13. I was a diehard fan, but I am not going to nobody's hotel. He dead ass wrong, but those young ladies have or had the power to say no. I believe you're right in terms of they had the power, but I think they were so caught up in the fact that they were going to have the opportunity to hang out with R. Kelly, probably something that they could brag about to their friends. They certainly didn't expect to be brutally raped.
Yeah,
it's real talk.
Yeah.
And this show is called Men's Choice. You get this shit? Men's Choice? See that shit? She said this shit is called Men's Choice. And we talk about a fucking pedophile.
Okay, so, but you all never came up with anything. I said it's freestyle.
Hey,
Men's Choice.
But
y'all
want to talk about? The shit is Men's Choice.
Yeah,
you get it?
What I'm saying is,
Robert.
I really believe that they had a choice,
Nathaniel,
and they chose to go up in the room. First of all, they dead ass wrong for sneaking out the house.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Let's not suspend that. No, they dead wrong for sneaking out the house. Now it's unfortunate the situation happened, but okay, if you sneak out, I promise.
Two wrongs don't make a right.
I understand that
because they snuck out the house.
No, that's not what I'm saying.
I'm asking a question.
What I'm saying is that
objective.
They should have never.
She's leading the witness.
You're
badgering the witness. You're interrogating the witness.
Okay, I'm gonna shut up.
No, what I'm saying is that
Robert,
if you decide to make grown Robert. Women decisions, then you're gonna have to deal with grown women. Choices.
I disagree with that.
I disagree because here's the deal. People going to make bad choices, right?
Right.
Those girls made a bad choice, put themselves in a bad situation.
Absolutely. Okay.
Now, they were the only children in this situation.
Right.
So now there's a village of adult dudes in there that should have made a better decision for them on their behalf as a responsibility.
Yeah.
Period. You know, because people are going to make bad decisions and think that they didn't come out there thinking that they were going to be treated like that.
Yeah. And I think that they didn't have a choice in being able to get out of there because he has an entourage. What the fuck was they going to do?
Yeah, you're right.
Robert.
Okay. Well, why is it that it's never... Will you hear of any females celebrities that's done that to men? I'm quite sure. You know, if Whitney Houston invited me up to her room, I'm gonna tag it.
But you're not underage.
If I was underage, I would still tag it.
But let me tell y'all something. I'm a little low on money, so I'm gonna go public with Oprah raping.
Did you say Oprah?
Wait a minute.
Oprah raping.
Wait a minute. She got short chains then, huh?
Oh damn!
I think Oprah's the only woman, who could come up and say, I need your man for the weekend, and your girl will probably be like, make sure you got on clean drawers.
Here's an extra pair just in case.
Yeah.
I mean,
your wife was like, baby, fuck her.
Mm-hmm. I think men, young guys' mindsets are different, mm-hmm. because if the shit was reversed, I don't think no young man would be like,
I was raped
by Halle Berry. Yeah. We gonna be like, man, I got that pussy.
You can't say that, you know, because there are dudes going through emotional shit because of teachers or people that they trusted. Look at R. Kelly. Whoever raped him, I'm sure she was fine.
Who do you think it was? His sister?
I think it was his sister.
You know what I'm saying? But look at the damage of what was done. She probably set in motion a chain of events that affected scores of people. You know what I mean? Whoever raped him and his brother.
Yeah. And he isn't the only one. And that's the thing. When people aren't getting help, they grow up carrying that, and for some, they don't break the cycle. They continue. They carry it on because they've never gotten help. So I'm going to shift gears a little bit and say, look at all of the men that were altar boys that were raped by priests. And here's the thing that I think I'm starting to understand that process a bit. And when I say, like, the Pope is the most powerful man in the world. Now, let me ask y'all a question. How many priests have you ever heard of that has been criminally prosecuted for molestation?
Man.
They prosecute them, they just keep it on the low.
Yeah.
And because they can't charge them criminally because that is a Vatican law.
But that's
Did you
been
all
going,
know that?
That's been going on for centuries, though. There's been... There's a pope that actually died having sex with a woman. You know what I mean? It's been a lot of corruption throughout the... Because I'm a history geek. And it's a very powerful position.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not limited to priests. There's a... Remember a few weeks ago, there was stories about nuns.
Well, I brought that up because they are not criminally prosecuted for those molestations. What happens is they get sent to another parish. I feel like it's like free will to molest these little altar boys.
They get sent to like Sandtown, Winchester.
Where they get fucked up.
I won't go to Baltimore. I ain't going to Baltimore. So can you wanna play the R. Kelly thing?
Yeah, okay, here it is. That shit.
Yeah, Keith said white privilege.
Yeah.
That's definitely it.
Papal privilege.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, here's the R. Kelly in Africa, serenading 14-year-old girls.
Do you have your passport?
I
did
that.
You get your shots?
I saw that.
Girl, would you like to come back with Rob to America? America. Do you have your passport? Did you get your shots? Girl, would you like to come back with Rob to America? America.
Oh, he really put that in the song.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's in between songs. Yes.
Do you have your passport?
He's on stage. If you listen to the, if you ever see the video, he's on stage right now.
Oh my God. Turned that bitch into a concert.
Now he's singing
I
like
see
he.
If he freestyled that shit.
Do you have your passport?
But the thing about it,
have all your shots.
the thing about it, he's singing that hard as I don't know, like he in church.
Does he mean that?
Like he in church about
this
asking
nigga
little
here.
Asking right. girls and like
damn,
like, he's in Ethiopia. You know what I'm saying?
And, that's crazy.
And like I said, where it's not uncommon for 14 and 15 year, you
right.
know, when you're in one of the,
so
any of them,
yeah. and being able to express that,
and everybody cheering. You see what I'm saying?
That made me want to go into a senior citizen
nobody
home.
No censors came and rushed him off stage.
No,
that was inappropriate.
In
no.
fact, they probably propositioned him. How much are you willing to pay?
He probably had
for X amount of girls.
An
you
exchange,
know what I'm
an exchange rate. He probably had 10 of them.
Exactly.
I'm going into the senior citizen building tomorrow.
Right.
Look for some cool.
I'm gonna hook up an amp and a mic with that same music. Right. And I'm going to look at each one of them senior citizens in their eyes and say,
that is 16. Well, let me say this. If you're
Do you have your SSI check? Do you have your pudding? Is your wheelchair electric? Can we keep on moving? I'm giggling right now. You know what? Fuck you, dick man. That's fucked up, man.
Where he can say that.
He's daring people.
He's there, exactly.
And he was doing that for the last 30 years. I mean, no, he wasn't playing that long, but you know, he was doing that since his first album. He's like hiding in, call it hiding in plain sight. He's telling you, like okay, I'm not gonna hide from this. And look, he married Aaliyah, and she's singing "Age Ain't Number the Number."
Yeah,
come on.
And nobody questioned that. Her parents allowed him to go.
We questioned it, but we accepted it. That's the thing about
it. But again, it goes back to her parents. They allowed her to go with this man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, okay, let's just say right is right and wrong is wrong. But with that right there, that's enough to nail him.
But who says that's not creative? Who says that's not creative liberty?
But even though over in Ethiopia, they can't use that here in America, right?
I don't know, but he ain't doing anything. He's just singing. He's mocking what he's doing. He's mocking the establishment. I mean, and they got music. He could put music behind it. So he said in a rehearsal, "Hey, y'all play this." And then go with me, and he got background singers. Passport. Come on, y'all.
Right.
You know what I mean? What about all of them?
They was harmonizing, making sure that they understood that you need your passport.
Get your shots.
Point. It goes back to that's how comfortable he was being able to do that because he's been getting away with this shit for years.
And that ain't too long ago. I think that's less than 5 years old.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He went up there on stage and sold out arena in Ethiopia.
Yeah.
I'm going to take you with
and
me
I think
to help
that's
get
probably
your,
why did he you get your he shots. Was invincible. Because he hasn't been convicted. He's been doing it for years and haven't been convicted.
And just imagine how many little girls he probably had in that room.
Yeah.
That night.
Yeah.
With the exchange rate, it's like $1. One American dollar is like 500 of their dollars.
Right. Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Because I know. It's like you go back there, we can get a babysitter. We're talking about a certified nurse for like a month for like less than $40.
Wow.
Who could who will stay with your kids around the clock.
Mm-hmm. Over in Ethiopia?
We're talking about the exchange rate.
Right. The money. Right.
Yeah. Damn.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So if he gives somebody $100, that's a dollar to him.
Yeah.
You see and she'll take that money home to her family.
Yeah.
You see, and that's what I'm saying. When you over in them other countries like that,
it's
a different ball game.
Yeah, yep. Definitely.
Damn.
And I'm just saying. I know we say this in jest, but it's some gravity to this situation, you know, and just kind of put things in perspective. It, you know, all the people that enabled him all this time is you know, at some point we all gotta be like, okay,
we have to take ownership of our role and allowing this to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Well, at least they're not talking about Bill Cosby no more.
Yeah,
but
just imagine you win the talent contest in jail 5 years in a row, then you got Bill Cosby coming in there, Jussie Smollett coming in there, and R. Kelly. You ain't gonna win nothing.
No, let me tell you like this. If you got Bill
Cosby.
Who's
drugging who?
Bill Cosby is
favorite, so. Who's plugging who?
You got talent. Empire.
That talent.
The Cosby Show.
Okay.
R. Kelly. And who else?
Bill
Cosby going to be telling jokes.
Jussie Bill, R. Kelly. Mm-hmm. Somebody else, ain't it?
Some of them actresses that are being in jail now for the for the academic thing. Man, it's like the jailhouses. That town is going to be lit.
Motherfuckers just going to be going to jail on purpose. Like, yo, you don't know what it is? Man, I'll kind of get up in there, boy.
Right.
You know, the concert every night.
Yo, that is.
Comedians,
that talent show,
all types of shit.
Concert every night.
That talent show in the D block going to be off the hook.
Oh, yeah. By the way, our call-in number is 855-493-6499.
Line 1 and 2 is open. Just call
got
in.
Got Nick on the ones and twos.
Call in and let us know your thoughts.
He going to be doing... He came out with Trapped in the Closet, Trapped in the Jail Cell.
I thought about the Trapped in the Closet thing.
Somebody need to do a fucking skit on that, yo.
Like
that shit would be funny, son.
No, I was like,
Trapped in the Jail Cell?
And think about it. But I'm trapped in the closet.
Nate, you might have to do it, Nate. Nate, you might have to write. I can get the instrumental, Nate.
I'll be the one to do it.
Was that his big, I'm seeking help?
I don't know, because
I'm trapped in the closet.
All I know is
I got an idea, Nate.
Let's do it.
Nate.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Hey, we're going to do that shit.
We're going to do it.
No, trapped in the jail cell. And we're going to say Nate going to be R. Kelly.
Because I'm trapped in the jail cell. Jail cell. With bars all around me. I'm trapped in the jail cell.
Now, here's my question.
With a guy with tattoos of three.
Yeah, he's going to jail. I don't think he's going to jail no more. He's going to go to jail. It ain't no more because everybody bailed out.
He's going to jail.
Yeah. You know, they might get him for child support, but he already served some time, but he's going to go to jail.
Trivia question.
Mm-hmm.
How many motherfucking chapters did he do to that shit?
24.
Y'all sure?
I think it's 24.
How many what?
Chapters to Trapped in the Closet did he do?
I'm going to say 24.
Oh, wait.
He did 24?
69.
23, 22.
Oh,
68,
God.
And you owe me one.
68.
I think after number 6, I felt like they were starting to get corny.
Yeah.
Damn.
I watched it to the end, but I jumped in. I turned it on when it was like halfway through.
Okay.
And it still was long.
I fell asleep on half of that shit. Like,
yeah. Still was long in the moment.
But it's like, good. But that the title was, good, was, I mean, think about it, y'all. The man been crying out for help for a long time. But I'm trapped in a closet.
But just imagine he had that creative liberty to do some crazy stuff like that.
Yeah.
And it was a success. Everything he touched turned into a hoe. I mean, gold.
I just thought that every time I thought that he was going to get to the good part, it'll die right back down. Now he don't know what to do. He's sitting there eating his dinner, and Bob comes in and says, "Hello,
nigga, get your hand out of my pocket."
7 o'clock.
I asked Jackie, what's her next color? She says blue.
Because I'm trapped in the closet.
7 o'clock.
We thought it was going to be green. We thought it was going to be green.
Said blue, and I don't have a clue.
I said, Jackie, why your hair not blue? She says, I chose red.
It should be green.
But I said, you said it was going to be blue.
St. Patrick's Day.
But I said I wanted red. But you said it was going to be blue. But I said I wanted red. But you're fucking faking. Fuck you, don't judge me. You don't fucking know me. I'm the queen, you see. Damn!
So hey, look, one play, and he a thespian.
Okay. Thespian.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Shout out to the What If crew. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
That was his 1 minute and a half of fame.
My name is Nate. I couldn't make it through the doorway.
Oh, God.
And I said, what the fuck? So the sun come through. The walls came fucking down. I just looked at them. And they just looked at me. And I said,
is this a disturbance? Because you got to keep it low, 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 low.
Yeah, man, three.
Damn.
He was a police officer. Somebody reported a disturbance. You got to keep it low, low.
Now, that would have been hot. There we go. Damn. What fucking beans talk you come from, Goliath?
Yeah, that was funny.
I like that line.
He said, what beans talk you climb down from?
That was pretty clever.
And Nate was behind him like, dude.
He's like, damn.
That was a good. I ain't gonna lie, when he came out, that's when most of the energy picked back up.
It picked up.
7 o'clock. Yeah.
So I have to mention this. Next week, on the show, we're going to have Arthur.
Jackie just farted.
Robert.
I just cleared out this room. we're going to have Arthur.
Why I smell like cinnamon?
Because I'm bathing potpourri.
7 o'clock. She had her air freshener.
Hello, Tara.
She over here.
Nice to see you again.
Look, she over here queefing.
We're gonna have Arthur Dumasani Sawazi on the show. He has a book called 40 Lessons.
He's gonna come.
Actually, he was tuned in tonight. He's gonna come and talk to us about his book next Monday. So I'm looking forward to that. He also has a podcast that I think will actually debut next month.
Wow, okay. A lot of authors out there.
Robert.
Cool.
And then that's the 25th. So then on the 1st, I have author Tamara Charles coming down from Boston.
Wow.
I can get the people in here.
Real.
So, yeah, Robert. I'm looking forward to that.
And April the 1st, we're going to have
April Fools.
And R. Kelly.
All right.
R. Kelly. Say it right. R. Kelly.
Robert.
This shit ain't about music.
Is this camera facing me?
Is this the one? I couldn't get over that. That's like, is it what's on up with me? That, it's on me now.
What's up with that whistle? Is this a Lassie movie?
I got the shit looped.
Let's see.
May I need to turn that shit off?
Yeah, but in all seriousness, man, we gotta do better as a people. We gotta, you know, it's funny, but at the same time, there's a lot of people's lives that this man affected.
Yeah,
and you know, I'm sure when he was young, at the time he reached out for help and
part was ignored.
Because our community
didn't talk about that.
Yeah,
exactly. And there, I think there are countless of children that have been affected by a family member, you know, touching them inappropriately. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times they were shunned or, no, I don't believe you. And so then you have a generation of hurt, traumatized children that not all have been able to break that cycle, and then they grow up hurting other people. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I always feel like the conversations that we weren't allowed to have are the same things that have a big impact on our community and have done so much harm.
Yeah.
And so many people struggle to maintain healthy adult relationships because of the trauma they suffered as kids and never received help or never been able to talk about it. So we have to start having more dialogue, with our kids, and we certainly can't allow our babies to just go with somebody just because it could enhance their career. If you're not willing to take that trip with them, then they shouldn't be allowed to go.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, it's I understand what you're saying, but like I said, I see that one particular child, nothing wasn't stopping her from being with him. And I feel for the parents, because you have a girl, a daughter, who, aside from locking her in her room, what can you do?
Well, even in that case, could they have not accompanied her? Could they have rerouted their lives?
Well, from what I understand, you know, she snuck out. He was still keeping in touch with her on a down low.
Okay.
And he would have the resources where she would literally could sneak out and go down the block, and he'll have a car. He in Chicago, and he'd have somebody pick her up. That's the kind of resources this dude had.
Wow.
Well,
you know what I mean?
And then
put her on a plane.
Let's just switch gears a little bit. Summertime coming, ladies. You know, fellas, don't let these sundresses get you $70,000 in the rear child support. I'm just saying. These sundresses are coming out, and like the DJ's playing Charlie Brown, and the only dirtiest person on Charlie Brown was Pigpen. Some of you women, stay on top of your coochie this summer, please. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. Stay on top of your coochie.
This public service announcement was brought to you by
the Red House.
No, they ain't not no sponsor. We ain't gonna get them no more props. They ain't no sponsor.
This
public service announcement was brought to you by Boutte Wine. 69 Backlick Road, Man, Ancestor, Virginia.
This is why he's the quiet store.
Get yourself some Boutte.
Okay, I like that. That was pretty good. Your
couche.
Y'all have any announcements that y'all need to make before we tap out?
Nah, man.
What do you have coming up?
What I have coming up? It's starting to get warm, so I have a couple gigs coming up. The biggest thing is the Wine Fest.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, come on out. Support. Caribbean Wine Fest, Memorial Day.
May and July?
Memorial Day weekend.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. When is Memorial Day weekend this year?
On a Monday. Yeah. Boom, 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 boom.
Yeah.
He said, what date does July 4th fall on this year?
Oh, man.
This guy.
Let me tell you, it's funny you said that. I think I told somebody the joke that when I was coming up, my mother, you know, if I did something messed up, my mother would say this cliche: keep on, I'm going to know where you is every 30th day of May.
Wow.
Right? So I never understood that. And I never, and it didn't dawn on me until I got.
You an Ava?
Until I got a child.
Okay.
You were trying to survive.
Yes. Understood. And she kept saying, every 30th day of May, I'll know where you are. And I'm saying, what is so special about the 30th day of May? Then when I got a child and I went to Myrtle Beach one day, Independence Day. That's the 30th day of... Oh, my God. I'm sorry. I know that sounds corny.
Shit flew over my
but I over never my knew what the 30th day of May was.
Like,
all right, so let me entertain you. Independence Day for what?
I guess you'll know when she celebrated Independence Day where her son was.
Where's the gong show thing? You got the bong...
No, bong you, bong you.
Look, I asked one question, man. I'm like, and I still have this.
It's still what? Woo!
Independence Day.
She says, you keep on, acting up.
I get,
I'm gonna know where you are every 30th day of May. Which means she was gonna kill me and bury me on Independence Day, man. Come on, you know how them black parents was back in the day.
I still wouldn't have grasped that shit. And I'm not saying I'm the smartest. Turn them in the basket.
Really, man? Really, man? Oh, now I'm in the Twilight Zone?
None of us got it. We're like...
Twilight Zone now?
I'm waiting for Rich, because Rich is pretty good at picking up shit.
I'm in the Twilight Zone?
You did an album. You threw your hands up.
Is this camera on me?
He went deep in the catacombs with that. I don't know.
I ain't never heard that.
Y'all don't know what I'm talking about.
A lot of shit.
Tell me with this. I gave you 3 years of my life.
Robert. Robert.
I gave you 3 albums of Clues.
He kept trying to sell it, but I was lost. I was lost in the jungle.
I gave you 12 plays. I gave you Feel You on Your Booty. I gave you Throw Your Thong. Y'all ain't see what
I think. I think that when he stayed calm, I was like, okay, he gonna just remain calm. Because they said he walked off of a talk show, and the woman he kept telling the woman, if you're here to talk about my life, I'm gonna leave.
Yeah, he got up and walked.
And then she just itched for it. But she basically wanted to know about his song. What is his song saying? Mm. He said, you know what? Forget you.
Yeah, I saw
he got up, walked off.
He should have did that. He should have did that with Gayle King name.
You feel what I'm saying? Walked off. But then everything, when I'm watching, I'm like, okay, he's staying calm. But then when he got up and said, y'all fucking with my life.
And he all up on his tippy toes.
It reminded me of the scene in Training Day when Alonzo was like, King Kong ain't got nothing.
Yeah, that's what that reminded me of. Somebody did a meme of that and had the shit he was saying.
Yeah.
But Denzel.
That's what that reminded me of.
But just imagine if that was a 15-year-old girl.
And he all up
and acting like that.
And you that's what I was saying. The way he carried on, I said that is that same approach that he used to mind fuck those girls.
And they got his wife.
He played this shit when they came. They asked
her all kinds of questions. Was he ever like this when he was with you? And she gonna say,
She said he was.
I don't know. I was locked in the room.
I couldn't believe that was a daughter.
But she a clown too because. About 4 weeks ago, she went on Instagram and was like, was she with her new man? And she playing R. Kelly. And she was like, yeah, I'm playing my baby daddy music. Yeah, I'm playing my baby daddy.
Yeah. On Instagram?
Yeah, I wouldn't mess with her.
Yeah, but remember she was on that show with Prince ex-wife, Eddie Murphy ex-wife. And she talked about some of what she went through with him because she said that
it was the exes of
But I ain't down with that. But I'm just saying you making bad choices too.
Yeah,
you know because now you come you come across as with is tacky and it's tasteless.
It's very tacky. Yeah,
you know, stay private. You got kids involved,
right?
You know, so yeah. that's my whole thing with her.
Yeah, well, it'll be interesting to see. I just hope that the victims are able or are seeking counseling.
Yeah.
Because that is traumatic. And, yeah, we laugh and joke about it, but this is shit that happened. And I just want them to get healing, you know, so that they can possibly prevent this from happening to their children. You know what I'm saying? On that they can go on and have healthy relationships.
Do you have your passports? Did you get your shots? Did he really say that?
Tomorrow I am doing a 30-minute broadcast on National Broadcast Radio FM. I'm excited about that because I had an 8-minute segment a few weeks ago. I told y'all I thought I sucked. And they called me the next day and was like, it was the highest rated segment of the day. So I got a 30-minute spot, and I think they had like 2 or 3 sponsors for me for that show. that they're going to market to see how well it does.
So you're saying you thought you sucked? You sucked for 8 minutes.
This song is dedicated to my redhead homegirl.
Jackie, you've been doing it since day one.
I believe she's a guy.
We know that you can reach any higher heights.
I believe she's my man tonight.
You always look good to us. Here we go.
I used to think that I could not scream on.
No, we can't play this shit. We're going to get blocked.
I know. Because you know
that was like one of my favorite songs by him.
I like "The Storm Is Over." You know what I mean? That's a very inspirational song. The storm is over. Yeah, and beautiful song.
He made a song called "The Storm Is Over."
Yeah,
man. I had it. Let me see if I got that shit.
It was beautiful.
And then when the woman's fed up because everything
you just
said
went in my head,
and that song is pretty much true.
So
I said to myself,
so his
like,
experiences. I mean, like. His experience is probably...
Oh, wow. You're right. God damn.
What's up?
The storm is over now.
Oh, that's like almost a gospel song, man. Beautiful song. You never heard that?
He made great music.
You're going to have to listen to this shit offline.
Yeah, he made great music.
The storm is over.
But it doesn't excuse his behavior.
And right after that is... I'm like, how?
Oh, my God.
But I'm not going to lie. I like that, too. Huh? I'm not going to lie.
What happened was...
Oh, there you
go. We don't want to get blocked.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Shoot. And,
He had some shit, yo.
He did.
He has a portfolio of... I mean,
bangers.
Look at "You Are Not Alone." He wrote for Michael Jackson.
Yeah. Right.
Shoot. Hotel? Yeah. That was the joint.
You know,
joint.
Him and Michael Jackson, he was telling Mike, "You ain't alone. I'm doing the shit you doing."
Mm-hmm.
But that's...
Girl,
maybe,
you want to come to my hotel?
See, but if he would have took the same approach...
I think I have a...
He should have took the same approach that Michael Jackson took.
On the Mike shit?
Because I always looked at him
as a kid,
for one, and number two, right? That's how I never looked at him as
being guilty. You ain't have a crush on Mike when you was young.
Children, never.
Yeah.
And then I say, if that did happen, then it goes back to the parents, because if this man is constantly being accused of this, why the fuck do you keep sending your children to stay with him?
Absolutely.
You know what
Let's just ask Macaulay. I'm quite sure he knows.
Please, man.
That's if he's not home alone.
I appreciate him as an artist and everything. And I won't put nothing past anybody. But if I was a parent, Michael Jackson couldn't even watch my kids on TV.
Damn.
I'll be damn.
Damn.
You know what I mean?
To be turn him off.
You know? But I everyone's guilty until proven innocent. Well,
absolutely.
Innocent until proven guilty. And of course, you know, he's not here to speak for himself, so I'm going to let it go. But
but you got to admit, though, it was kind of crazy he holding that baby outside of that balcony like that, though.
We'll look at her now. She a model. You know what I mean? She,
who, his daughter?
Yeah, Paris.
Was she in rehab?
Yeah. Why so she was Blanket?
Yeah.
Who was Blanket?
I can't. Oh, God. I cannot with him.
I think she was Blanket. Well, I mean, but to be honest, back in my mind, I think...
Who was Blanket?
I think he's guilty. I think OJ did it. A lot of things.
Who was Blanket?
To the OJ shit.
I'm just saying.
Oh, man.
I'm just saying. I think
wouldn't that be something?
I think he might be guilty.
Blanket just one day looking for a man.
That, I'm with you on that.
And she be like,
I think with him, here's what I'm going to say to that. He got away with it. But then he started doing a lot of stupid shit.
No, that's disgusting.
I'm talking about OJ.
OJ.
Yeah, I'm talking about OJ.
Well, the only reason why he got caught this time because he went back to get his stuff.
Which was stupid. He should have went to jail.
That was entrapment.
Yeah. OJ was in the back laughing at motherfuckers after he got found not guilty.
Yeah, but they,
yeah.
But they hit him financially. You see what
I'm saying? Yeah, they tore his ass up.
Civil court, you don't have to prove half the things you have to do in criminal court. Ain't that something?
But you know, everybody involved in that case, believe it or not, paid one way or another.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah.
But the real question is, who is Blanket? Would it be funny if she out on a date, a blind date, but like, hey, how you doing? My name is Blanket. Really? What is your name? Sheets! In the news today, Michael Jackson's daughter, Sheets, meets her new husband, Blanket.
And they had a sister named Pillow. Didn't you hit that?
About that one on the next show.
You're going to save that.
Pillow going to therapy.
Because this joke can give lessons, and I'm just
going to
leave it at that.
Oh, damn.
I'll teach you that shit.
I just realized that joke was about me. God damn, what?
I figured you went over your head.
I changed your name from Quiet Storm to Speak Up a Motherfucker. For real.
Yeah, he gets a million, damn. I'm telling you. And you over there laughing.
Sneak up on a motherfucker.
Yes, Lord. That's why he's quiet storm.
He was laughing at his own self.
I won. I was like, yeah, I'm thinking with that pillow sheets. He gonna say pillows. I'm like, yeah, okay.
Well, boys and girls, that's a story for another show.
That's for another show, because that's gonna be a long one.
Pillow.
Dr. Love.
Not I.
I stuck my wood in the
pillow. Not I.
You stick your wood in the pillow.
I did not touch that pillow there. I did not touch that pillow anywhere.
You did not eat green eggs and ham. Right now you look like green eggs and ham. All
right, so who is your favorite cast member from the show?
Really? Queen, really? You said that they look like a checkerboard, really? Really?
I'll take the checkerboard over green eggs and ham.
Hey! I don't mind.
Yesterday,
she got them bees from Africa.
You get your shots. You got your passport.
Or did the pillow get their shot? I'm just saying.
Yo, this is one of the funniest shows, y'all.
Yeah, we needed that after last week.
Look, no, don't do that. Don't do it.
We're out of town.
Let me tell you why I say that, because your brother said, man, this is the cleanest show ever. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah, he did come and say that.
Yeah.
He said, oh, until I see them sitting there, I knew the show was going to be clean. I was like, no, we just decided to give a pass on this one.
And I started to shake shit up a little bit, but I was like, I'm going to keep the monkey in the box.
Thank you.
Poor choice of words.
Thank you.
I must resist commenting.
It was right there, yep. And I said, look.
Nate, he said my Nate,
and I don't know. He might have got excited and started rubbing the muscles and shit. I don't know.
I definitely would have fell out the chair, bruh.
Kept the monkey in the box.
Bruh.
Some jokes are just served up like.
Exactly.
Uh-oh.
But I think his mic fell, and I said, oh, your mic went limp. He didn't catch it.
He didn't catch it.
I was like, okay, Mr. West, Cornell West.
Yeah, you said that, and I had to think about it. You were right.
Kind of remind me of Cornell West.
Yeah.
My body. All right, y'all, we're going to end the show.
We're
going
to end the show right now, because it's about to go really, really left. You know, so tune in next week when we have... Wait a minute, let me find that name again.
Asuki Basaki Asaki.
I'm not with you. Hang on.
Robert.
We're going to have author Dumasani Sawasi on the show. His book is called You've been 40 practicing Lessons.
Saying his name.
I gotta get it right. You know?
Be ready, Mr. Sawatchi.
Cause we gonna play for his name.
And he really, I mean, he was really keep great to talk to on the phone, real down to earth, so he'll fit in great with the team.
Cool.
Be ready, Mr. Sawatchi.
To having him Sirachi. Come on the show.
Sawatchi.
Kimosabi.
Karaki. How you say his last name?
Sirachi. Join us next week. Same time, same place.
Download, same bat station.
Download the Mixed Radio Station app.
Live app. And make sure y'all can call in. We're going to start getting this shit right.
Yeah,
y'all can
start calling in. Yeah.
Call in, damn it.
All right. Thank you.
And this show is sponsored by Nate Christmas Outfit.
Oh, we're not going to go with Christmas Outfit.
No, that was good, yo.
Another
good.
Christmas Outfit. We got Santa Claus coming.
That was good.
Matter of fact, between me, you, and Jackie, Santa Claus coming.
Say what you want, but that shit was good.
All right, y'all, we out.
You look like the Jolly Green Giant sitting over there. I ain't going to lie.
You know, I will never wear this shirt again ahead of this goddamn job.
I thought you looked like Patrick's day was the day.
Okay. Turn the goddamn shit off.
After the show.
Shenanigans.
Exactly.
Goddamn. Goddamn.
I said, damn, am I confused?
Is this still Jackie got the glow in the dark hands.
Right now.
Oh, shit.